Bonjour, mesdames et messieurs. In this video, I want to show you how to import and a really cool workflow to find really fast your best photos. And of course, we're going to do some retouching together. I just spent a whole week in Miami trying to shoot for maybe my next book, and I really enjoyed the city. I took lots of photos, and I'm going to show you something I've been doing for years to really organize my photo really well, find the best one really fast, and retouch them. Let's do it. All right, so I have my SD card with all the photos from Miami. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna go, I click here and I'm gonna go to other destination. So I'm here in my travel photos folder, which is on Dropbox. I use Dropbox as a backup. I have Dropbox Unlimited, but you know, I do this for a living. And so in this Dropbox folder, I got something called travel photos. And in this one, I'm gonna create a folder called Miami, but unfortunately with this option of Lightroom, you can't. So I have to go here. New folder, let's call it Miami. Okay, and then in Miami, so I'm gonna pick the Miami folder here and click choose. In that folder, I'm gonna organize it into by date. And the date format is gonna be 2021, 2021-05, you know, and the different dates. And what that's gonna give me is I'm gonna have a Miami folder and I'm gonna have for every day I shot, I'm gonna have the photos of that day. I really like that. So, I'm gonna copy them, not as DNG this time, I'm gonna copy them as the original Sony RAW file. I do this because these are very light RAW files anyway, and it's faster than to do DNG. So I'm gonna import this. It's gonna import a whole week of photos, and it's gonna do that day by day, which I found really, really useful. I love to go through my photos day by day. All right, so the photo have imported, and you can see here in my library, I got 2021, I got April 28, April 30, 2nd of May, 4th of May the 4th be with you, and 5th of May. And this one, for example, look at this. This day I shot 1,192 photos. It's kind of crazy. Also, what I do is, I forgot to mention, but when I import, I use the option of embedded preview in it, so I can go really fast. Look how fast I can go. I shot with a Sony, like really very, very fast in the Everglades, very fast photos. Anyways, so I'm gonna give you the example on the day before I left, and because I think it's one of my favorite photos. So what I do is once I imported the photo, I take a day, and then I go through, and if I find a photo that I think has some kind of potential, I give it a 1 star. So I just press 1 on my keyboard. So let's see, maybe this one, I'm gonna give it a 1. This is the Art Deco District in Miami, and it was a great sunset. So I did a lot of panos too. That's a pano. Okay, that's a pano. So when I have a panel like this, I select all 4 photos. I think this one can be kind of cool. I right click, I first give it a color like red, and then I give it 1. I think this one has some potential to be something. All right, so this one, well, I'm not crazy about this one. This one, maybe I give it a 1. Here is another pano. Usually when I do pano, I go portrait, so I can really see I went pano. So same thing, this one, I'm going to select that, and I'm going to go 1 and color red. So usually when I did a color red, the next one I do yellow so I can see them better. I use that for my panos. Okay, this one, yeah, this is like just a 2-photo pano, and then I did a 3-photo pano on this one. This one can be kind of cool. I think I'm gonna prefer this one, so I'm gonna go here, 1, and then color label red, and then I go through. This one I don't like, it's somebody in the shot. Oh, this is like a pano where I go like 1 up, 1 down, 1 up, 1 right, 1 left. That can be kind of cool. This one can be kind of cool. I actually really like this one. So this one, I'm gonna give it a 2. When I see that something has a lot of potential, I give it a 2. And then color label, let's go to yellow, and let's carry on. Yeah, on that night, I did lots of pano. This one, yeah, this one's okay, I give it a 1. Took a lot of good shots that night. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's another pano. Yeah, this one is kind of cool, so I'm gonna give it a 1. I mean, usually I don't take so much good photos, quote unquote. It's just because that night was really nice. So, and that's just my workflow. So this one, I'm gonna give it a yellow. And then I do that for everything. So let's go faster. All right, so now one. So I've given one star to the photo that I think has potential, and there's a few that I gave a two star to. So usually I always start by retouching because I have my two star photos. So for example, this is a cool panel. So let's select this, right click, photo merge, panorama, and okay, perspective doesn't really work. Let's try cylindrical on this one. Yes, cylindrical might be better. Let's try spherical. Yeah, spherical is pretty good. One thing I use a lot when I do pano now is I use a new feature called fill edge, and that's gonna fill in all the missing pixel by creating it. Okay, I know some of it was gonna be weird, but it's usually it does a good job in the sky. So then I merge this one and it's gonna make it into a stack. Okay, next one, this is the next pano. So while this is happening, I just go and do the next one, photo merge, panorama. And I've never seen this photo. I'm actually doing this live. I've never seen this photo. That might be really bad. Create stack. I'm going to use fill edge. So to fill in all of that. And I love to work with one camera. Like I was just going on with a 2470 2.8 and going really fast. I love the convenience of going fast. Making sure I only have the two stars. And this is the last panel that's two star. Same idea. It was a panel night. It was a panel night, my friend. Okay, fill edge. Okay, so now I've got three panels to work with. This one, and this one. And you see they're into stacks. All right, guys, so now I'm gonna use some of my preset. I always use my preset to retouch my photo. It just goes much faster. You can get a whole bunch of preset. The link is right under the video. All you have to do is click. You put in your first name, last name, your email. You're gonna get my daily newsletter if you do that. I send an email every day, but with some also free videos and some really cool tricks and some great promotions. Also, once you get the preset, you get the option to get my full pack of preset at a really low price. So check it out if you want to. So here I am, I'm back here, and I'm gonna try my golden hour preset. See, ooh, the golden hour preset does well, because that was really like a golden hour. I think I'm gonna go with golden hour, maybe dark, or yeah, dark. And when I use some of my preset, the first thing that I do is I check my black points. You see it's too strong, because preset, you have to adapt them. And then I use the white point, making sure I don't have anything burn. Okay, I usually add a bit of contrast. On this one, I think I'm gonna add back more blue. I mean, it was a crazy night. Make sure everything is sharp. Yeah, it's very sharp. And that's a cool shot of Miami. And I usually would spend more time, but the preset gives me a good idea. If I like it with the preset, I give it a 3-star. And you see here, something is weird because we did the pano trick. That's fine. I'm gonna go 16:9 because that's what I usually do most of my work with, and I'm just gonna focus a little more on that sky here. Voila. Okay, and I really like this one. Let's check out this one. This is like more blue hour, so let's use the blue hour preset maybe. Blue hour light. Yeah, blue hour normal. Okay, same thing. You hold on the option key, you check the black points, way too strong on this one. The white point, I can make it better. And there's too much skies. So on this one, I'm gonna 16:9, and voila. Okay, looks like I messed up here. See, this one is blurry, so this one is not good. So this one, I give it a 0. I messed it up. Okay, let's try this one. This is also a blue hour, but I think I'm good. There was still some sunset, so I'm gonna use a sunset preset on this one. Yes, sunset. And I don't like how the rod is curvy, so I'm gonna crop that. I'm gonna go 16:9. 16:9 is really something I do a lot with the galleries and the books that I do. Yeah, so now that works kind of better for me. Voila. And this one is kind of cool. I'm gonna give it a 3-star. So I always give it a 3-star when I apply some of my presets. So now let's see if we can find some other one in the 1-star that I kind of like. Okay, so I'm also gonna do this one really quick. So I'll go to photo merge, panorama. Now this one, if I use cylindrical, you see how the building is gonna be very round. So I'm gonna use perspective. It's gonna look weird. That's totally fine. I'm gonna do a bit of boundary wrap to make it more straight. Not too much, just a little bit. And I'm gonna do some fill edge. I always do fill edge as a security because it's gonna give me some more skies and some more road. I merge it. But then, you know, of course, I kind of crop it first. All right, so that's the result. So what I do is I usually start with one of my presets. That's a golden hour, so I'm going to use like a golden hour circle. Now, I know there's a lot of weird stuff there, so I'm going to go 16 by 9, and I'm going to go here where the action is. Okay, and yeah, it's kind of weird. So on this one, let's go to the auto feature, see if we can make it more straight. Yeah, it's I don't like how the photo is kind of like this, so let's see, can we do something about it? I'm gonna rotate it a little bit. Yeah, it's really leaning toward, let me see if I can crop a little more on this one, just to be there. Yeah, it's not bad, the sky is a little too much. I don't like when it was really, really strong, the sky. Okay, so I'll give it a 2-star, I don't really like it. Anyway, so let's look at the 3 stars that we did. At the end, I only had this one, and this one, which I really like. This is the before and this is the after. I really like this one. And so I'm just gonna go day by day in Miami and do that. I just thought I wanted to share that with you. If you wanna have my preset, they are amazing. I only work with my preset. The link is down below. Check it out. If you can get the full package, it's at $27. It's the best deal ever. And I'll see you in another video. Mesdames et messieurs, au revoir.